Well, hello, oh, hello, the Neon Annihilator. Damage removes sappers. What? What does that even mean? What damage? Oh, the damage of the weapon. But I mean, anyone can remove a sapper, right?
I mean, hello.
So I guess you mean it removes it in one hit? But doesn't the homewrecker do the same thing? Damage removes sappers, that's right. It does the exact same thing. 100% critical hit versus wet players. That's cool. But no random critical hits and minus 20 damage versus players. Alright. Let's give it a spin. Just wanna, I've had this one before, haven't I? I haven't exactly used it. What does it even say? It looks like Chinese. Well, I'll just get right to smelting. Well, which ones were I was I gonna? It doesn't really matter. Do I get to keep it even though I've gotten rid of it? That sure is how it seems. Okay, today is... What happened? Why did I teleport? Said I died, but I respawned in an instant. Why was his health gray? So perhaps I have some things to talk about in this video. I was gonna talk about the plans for my YouTube channel. I mean, I'm not even sure there's a purpose to making these videos. I've talked about that before. It feels wrong for me to make these videos now. I don't feel as good about it anymore. Feels pointless to be making these videos. But I have some plans. The plan is to... So right now I'm playing Team Fortress 2, but perhaps I'll return to Pokemon White. And I'll finish playing Pokemon White. And then I'll do a let's play of Pokemon Emerald. And after I've finished the let's play of Pokemon Emerald... Shit, then there's Glazed. Fuck Glazed. I think I'm just gonna abandon Glazed for now at least. I'll make a let's play of Pokemon Emerald. I have a whole team planned out for it actually. I suppose I can tell you my team I've planned. I thought they were alphabetically sorted. Now they're only on my Tumblr page, my Tumblr blog. On there, I've posted it on there, and there they're alphabetically sorted. So the plan is Cacnea, Chimecho, Clamperl, Claydol, Nosepass, and Rosalia. You can't get Rosalia and Emerald, but you can trade between games, right? So we can just imagine that I've traded it from Ruby Sapphire, and I'll give it to me as a starter, I suppose. All the other 5 Pokemon can be obtained in Emerald. It's a great plan. Notice how 4 of those start with a C. Nice coincidence. I don't know, it's just kind of alliterative. What is going on? Society, WTF. After I've finished my Let's Play Pokemon Emerald, I will go back to my Let's Play of Ocarina of Time. And I want to play Majora's Mask too, but like I have to play Ocarina of Time first, I suppose. So, but the problem is that I can't play Ocarina of Time. I just can't. It's not possible for me. I just can't do it. Especially if I'm not cheating, like looking stuff up on the internet. Walkthroughs. I can't play Ocarina of Time. I don't know how anyone can. I mean, I feel very dumb. I feel worthless because I can't play Ocarina of Time. I'm sick of every goddamn Zelda fan insulting me because I can't play Ocarina of Time. I'm sick of it. It really hurts. And I kind of want to do this Let's Play just to spite them. But like, I mean, it's not exactly spiting because it'll just be, hey look, I can't play this fucking game. And yet I'm making a lot of videos of me playing it. See? And they'll just think, dude, and the truth will be, reasonable people will say you're just wasting your time. But I feel deranged. Also Pyro, I see. I feel completely powerless in Ocarina of Time. And I don't know why every goddamn person loves that game so fucking much. And I mean, they'll just consider me fucking worthless because I can't fucking play it. I'm sick of it. And like, but at the same time, this feels like something I can't really do anymore. Trailblazer. Ignite 10 enemies that have recently used the teleporter. Okay, cool. Well, okay, so what kind of map is this anyway? Mercenary Park, it looks like an attack and defense map. Linear single stage. Blue must capture all control points in a set order. And it's single stage. Right, it's single stage. Cool, so, yep, blue must capture all control points in a set order. That is correct. I see. 1, 2, 3. There they are. All right. And we're not doing so well. Oh, Water. I'm drinking water. I really feel like I drink too much water. I don't know how much other people drink. I just drank a cup of tea before making this video. Uncle Dane made a video about random crits. That sounds like it might be interesting. Remove random crits from TF2. Alright. Uncle Dane, I want to vintage Jarrity. Okay, so we did capture the first one, and here's the second one. Let me go get some health. And I've run out of fucking ammo. Alright, well, actually doing pretty well for ourselves now. We have 11 whole minutes. I feel like this is something I can't do anymore, this, like, spiteful let's playing, because... Have I ever done this before? Let me just think about that first. Like, is there any time I've done, like, a let's play that has just been, like, out of frustration? I mean, I have played Ocarina of Time, yes. I've made 4 Ocarina of Time videos, but only 4. That wasn't very much. So perhaps I haven't. Yeah. So, but this is like, I guess just my, I was gonna say my general negativity in my past videos. I feel like when I was, I don't know if I was that negative in my videos, but when I guess it doesn't necessarily have to be about negativity, more like about making the videos at all, which is what I was talking about earlier in this video with the stuff like, this feels pointless now. When I was younger, I thought I was gonna live forever, so the video, like, it didn't matter that I made so much video that was like, you know, difficultly gonna be able to watch all of like myself in the future, which is something I think about nowadays. And also, I suppose you could say that negativity, negativity didn't feel as bad. Because I was going to live forever, so it's like it doesn't even matter. This isn't even a large part of my life. It's just, I can play with it. I can become this character, which is funny. This funny character. And it doesn't really even matter because I'm not going to be this character forever. It's just a funny little thing. If that makes any sense, perhaps not. Like, I can't really go on a rant anymore now without feeling, like, guilty. Because I feel like I'm wasting my life. I can't go too far into the details of what makes me upset, like petty stuff. I could show you an example right now of something which kind of annoyed me the other day. So, well, this happened like yesterday. I don't know. When did this happen? This indeed happened yesterday. So I was just on YouTube, like, you know, I've been waking up late these past days, or so. Not these past days, but, well, yesterday and today, I suppose. And by the way, I'm starting to get a bit much refined metal. Like, at some point, I'm gonna start deleting these. Because it's just too much. So anyway, I was just like going downstairs, and I was gonna listen to some music. I thought of Comme si ça tourne. I was gonna listen to that one. Turned out that the high quality one, which used to be on YouTube, had been removed. Copyright striked. And there was another version. Or, you know, like there was a re-upload, or not a re-upload, but someone else had uploaded Comme si ça tourne. So I listened to it, and it sounded weird. It was supposedly high quality, but it sounded weird to me. The vocals were too loud, and the instrumental was too quiet. It felt really off. I was just listening, like, the first 3 minutes, it felt really off. So I go into the comments, and other people have noticed the same thing. People were complaining about all the vocal noise at the, like, the last 3 minutes of the song or so. So some people really didn't like that. And I was like, yeah, I noticed that, yeah. Because I've been noticing it. I was only listening to the first 3 minutes and I noticed it. And that got me thinking, well, am I the only one who noticed it the first 3 minutes? Did no one else notice it? Like, the subtle differences? Does that make me real smart? But then there were all these other people in the comments who were praising this version tremendously. They were like, oh, I had always appreciated the song on a lyrical level, but damn, they do some crazy stuff there at the end that I never even noticed. Stuff like that. And people were like, damn, this is so high quality, I can't believe it. Wow, this is so high quality. So, like, the vast majority of people were completely confused. They didn't realize that it was another version entirely. They didn't realize that the vocal stuff they heard at the end wasn't even in the version that they'd listened to before. It literally wasn't there, and they were so confused. They were just really, really confused. And really, yeah. Of a very differing opinion from mine. I don't know, I can't quite handle that very well. When I disagree with everyone in the world, the vast majority anyway, there were like three people in the comments, or not three, that's a bit of, that'd be too little, but, I don't know, it feels like I'm drowned out. by everyone else. I mean, like, they just, they're just really confused. They didn't notice anything. And, like, I don't know if I'm ever that confused. Maybe I am in other aspects. But I don't know, it made me feel superior to them. And I could even continue this rant. This is more of a rant. Like, Evangelion fans, they sicken me. Kind of. I can't relate to them whatsoever. They're so insanely different from me. I can't handle it. The way they talk about Evangelion is not at all what I got out of it. There's this tweet the other day that Digine retweeted that made me unfollow Digine. Well, amongst other things. Digine, I don't like Digine's tweets. I really don't enjoy this. I had to unfollow. No. So what the retweet said was, if you don't think about Neon Genesis Evangelion every 3 hours for the rest of your life after watching it, congrats, you are mentally healthy. And I just don't understand what people think is so deep about Evangelion. I just see it as kind of just endearing. I don't see what's so, like, psychologically deep about it. It's like I and every other fucking Evangelion fan watched completely different animes. I don't understand what they're referring to. What did they see in it? What is so deep about it that you have to think about it every 3 hours? Not literally, of course, but still. What's up here? Another way to get to the control point, I see. Another route. I keep losing health. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Can't stay alive. Critical hit? What? I don't know, does the flamethrower get random crits? That wouldn't seem to make any sense. Well, perhaps it does. I wonder how many seconds exactly you can use the flamethrower for, because it before it runs out of ammo. I could do the math, like right now. Nah, this don't work. Goddamn. Okay. Okay, well, it kind of seems to be like 10 per second, so... If it's about 10 per second, that means... It's 20 seconds. GGWP not so easy, huh? How can there be Ubercharge after Ubercharge? What is this? A couple of days ago, in the evening, I was reading a book for once. You know, Unarranged Marriage by Bali Rai. And, I mean, I read like 60 pages. That evening, it was like the first time in a very, very long time that I actually enjoyed reading. I mean, I didn't enjoy it very much. I suppose it's a scale, and but I enjoyed it relatively much more than in a long time. First time in a long, long time, I would say. I don't know when the last time would have been, because I've only been forced to read pretty much. I might have kind of enjoyed reading Nekru's Daman. Maybe the Gregor books, although, I mean, wasn't that forced too? Like, I was forced to read in school. Like, sometimes, and so I would. But I got to pick the book, but I was, like, forced to read sometimes, I think. Fucking hell. keep saying that. I don't know what else is, how else to express this. I'll talk about it in a bit. I mean, when have I ever enjoyed reading freely? Freely read and, you know, I mean, seriously. How far back are we going? I mean, I was like reading that one book long time ago. I don't even remember what it's called. I talked about it in one of my, I've been making these private room tour videos that I'm not uploading publicly. I'm not publishing. I might publish them in the future. I don't know. I'm not publishing them for now, but there's this one book that I read, and I mean, I might have enjoyed that. You know, around that time, I was, you know, the fucking Hunger Games. I mean, I enjoyed reading the Hunger Games. Yeah, but that's about it. It's like very long ago. Oh, sure, there's also Holes by Lewis Satcher, which I suppose I kind of enjoyed. But then I stopped. I didn't enjoy it enough to want to read. I actually made an Instagram post about this, like when I was in Spain, in Andalusia. Almuñécar, to be more specific. In the autumn of 2017. Yeah, I was reading Holes by Lewis Satcher, but I said I didn't enjoy it enough to want to read it. So, but I mean, I didn't really feel like there was anything else I'd rather do that evening a couple of days ago. I was content with reading, you could say. I guess, to some extent. A relatively large extent, although it could be larger, I think. Could certainly be larger, I think. It really feels like I've never seen someone who is more hated than me. When it really gets down to it. The true me. Never seen anyone else who's more hated than me. It really feels that way. This sucks. Why do I feel slow? Oh, I had some sticky shoes on. I don't know how that happened, but I think that was what it was, but it seems to have passed now. Oh no. Why am I so stuck? Where am I? Well, that was a critical hit. You can even see it up there on the top right corner. Metamorphologue. Was that spy disguised as a blue team scout? That's what it looked like. Borgix. Oh, look at that guy. Has a Godfather profile picture. Critical. Thank you, medic. Ah, it's him, the Siberian Mafia, level 100. Russ. Be watching Healthy Gamer GG. Finished watching that video called Why Why People Don't Like You Dr. K Interviews. I find the title to be quite misleading. But yeah, so I watched all that now. Finished watching that video and then started watching this other one called Conquering Social Anxiety featuring Pooper Noodle, Dr. K Interviews. I find it quite difficult to relate to sympathize with Pooper Noodle. I'm finding it quite annoying to watch this. Would have been a good spot for the back burner to be used. Achievement, hot on your heels. Kill 50 enemies with your flamethrower from behind. Twilight Sparkle has found the Dead Ringer. Wow, you found the Dead Ringer? Damn. Found it. I had to craft it. Oh, he spoke. Well, how does it have a shield? There's a crocodile in this map? Why do I have critical hits? Wait a minute, I can just use my... Twilight Sparkle. God damn. Fucking. How can a little sentry like that do so much? Nice. Took him down with the homewrecker. Wow. If I hadn't used the flamethrower, Getrek 225 wouldn't have been taken out, but well, if I'd used the homewrecker, maybe I could have taken out the sentry and then taken out the engineer. What the hell is that flag behind Twilight Sparkle? Yeah, that's the lesbian flag. I don't even know what Mountain Lab is. It's another attack and defend map. It seems. Right, and it's another linear single stage. But maybe I should end the video here. Oh, it's this one. I'm lost. What was his name? Huh? Now I have two back burners, do I? Do I? Yeah. Back burner and third. Do this. Okay, cool. I don't never mind. I've been imagining in my head what it would be like to talk to Alok. You know, Healthy Gamer GG, and it would just like, I feel like I'm different from everyone else. And I feel like I'm, no one can sympathize with me. No one. No one can sympathize with me. No one cares. Alright, so Spy was able to backstab the heavy. There's this, I recently somehow, I don't know how I found this video exactly. I was rewatching one of Einstein's, you know, Shine PhD, Charles Hikaru Tachibana Schwingendorf's old videos. And, the anime man, Joey, is in that video, and they're having a conversation, and Joey says something which has stuck with me. It was in the Racism in Japan Experience video. Actually, I can play it to you because it's not going to get copyright striked.
I'm a victim. I'm the victim. I'm the victim here.
Welcome to the real world. Not everybody likes you, mate.
So confused. Oh, it's a transparent window. It's not a glass. It's not glass. It's just hollow. Controlled burn, 20 out of 50. I'm guessing that's burning someone on a control point. Actually, I just... never mind. Or... That... The Einstein clip I played might be a bit too loud. Because I'm gonna be raising the volume by 5 decibels, and it was at like -2 or something, so. For some reason, the last 2 Mountain Dews I've drunk have tasted kind of sickly to me. So maybe I don't like Mountain Dew as much anymore. Now Siberian Mafia level 100 Russ is on the other team. I see. Are we winning? We're winning. No? Yes? Last night I was just rewatching a bunch of Montefiantum, the Sune Grekland, Sune på bilsemester, and Sune Fjällen. Sun on a stick. Don't quite remember what that is. I was like trying to play Work Song today on the bass guitar. Not the bass line, well, I don't know, just like the main melody, you know, like on the really high notes, yeah, but it was on the bass guitar. But I mean, then again, I mean, in the actual song, the bass does play high notes, so. But I was playing all the notes, not just the bass notes. Isn't that going so well? Why was that pyro so strong? Extinguishing people now. It's going pretty well, except I've almost run out of ammo. It's going great. But I need more ammo. Deal with another pyro. Where do I find health? This drop is gonna kill me. Where's the health? Can't find it. Why did I get a critical hit? I guess that was a random crit. Shit, that's a lot. There is... I can't win a one-on-one fight because I'm too low on health. Where's more health? Maybe if I shoot at him from afar, but it's too fucking late. Ah, oh, there was health over there. Why am I spawning all the way back here? So the spawn didn't move. Well, that explains why I couldn't really find any spawn around here. He took the health. How do we get in there? I should have extinguished him. Thank you. Wait, do I actually gain health from extinguishing people? What? What happened? What do you mean removed by system? Feels like my life sucks right now. My eyes, they're tired, quite tired. My right eye especially. Gorge, but that's not the same as Five Gorge, which I played on, so this is new. Indeed. Get up in the morning, just up at night, and I wake up in the afternoon. I'm not doing what I should be doing. I don't even want to be anything. I don't have much desire for anything. Asexual quinoa. Rock Johnson rocking the Iman Anis profile picture. Oh, and I was also playing Taking a Chance on Love on the guitar. I was fiddling around with it like a few days ago, and I like discovered that I could play the melody. I figured out how to play the melody, or at least the main one, and can't take this. Also, I joined Lewis Rossman's Discord server the other day. And, like, I was surprised at how, like, rude people in that server are. Like, damn. Didn't expect that. I don't know if I can call it rude exactly, I'm kind of exaggerating. Heard the dead ringer. Useless water. Oh, I can't take this anymore. Can't handle this. And this guy is in big trouble. Oh, he made it. What the? Well, they're losing. They're losing quite badly. There's only 34 seconds left. One HP, oh my god. Encoding overloaded, what are you talking about? Okay, I'm gonna end the video here, I suppose. Goodbye.